Hello, my name is Oriol Farràs, and I'm presenting the work Secret Sharing Schemes for Almost All Access Structures. This is a joint work with Amos Beimel. In this presentation, first I will give an introduction to secret sharing schemes, and then we will see the results we got for secret sharing schemes for almost all access structures and for almost all graphs. And then we'll see some conclusions and open problems. Secret sharing scheme can be seen as a method to protect a secret in which we generate some shares from a secret. In order to facilitate the description of the scheme, we consider that there are some participants and each participant holds one of these shares. And there's a special participant called the dealer who holds the secret. Then from the secret and some randomness, the dealer generates some shares and each participant gets one share. And these shares are generated in such a way that some coalitions of participants can recover the secret from their shares. This subset of participants are called authorized. And the family of authorized subsets is the access structure of the scheme. Then we have other subsets that cannot get any information about the secret. And these subsets are called forbidden subsets. When we say no information, is in the information theory sense. In this talk, we only consider perfect schemes that are schemes in which every subset is either authorized or forbidden. And now we'll see a simple secret sharing scheme that will be useful to introduce some notation. So consider a case that we have a secret from a finite field. We have four participants and we want to share the secret in such a way that the only authorized subset is P. So P can receive, so all participants together can recover the secret, but any subset of size 3 or less cannot obtain any information about the secret. So the dealer can choose three random elements from the finite field and give one random element to each participant, except for the last participant who will receive S minus the sum of the random elements. We can see here that all participants together can recover the secret by just summing their shares, but any subset of size 3 or less cannot get any information about the secret. So in order to measure the efficiency of the schemes, we use the share size, which is the logarithm of the size of the set of possible shares. Since each share is in FP, in this case, the share size is log P. In some schemes, the size of the shares may be different from different participants. So in general, we consider the max share size. In this case, is still log P. And in some cases, we will also consider the total share size, which is the sum of the share sizes. That is for log P in this case. This scheme is linear over FP, which means that the secret is in FP and shares are linear combinations of the secret and the randomness. Linear schemes have homomorphic properties that are useful for in cryptography. And so this is a special family of schemes that will be considered also during the talk. Now we'll see some properties of the access structure. The access structure of a scheme is monotone increasing because, well, if we have an authorized subset, any superset of this subset will also be authorized. Therefore, the access structure is determined by the minimal access structure, which is the family of minimal authorized subsets. In order to describe access structure, in this presentation, we'll use these pictures, in which we have the power set of the set of participants, and we paint it red those subsets that are authorized. For this example, the minimal access structure is the family of the subsets 1, 2, 2, 3, and 3, 4. We'll go back to this description, and we know that every monotone increasing family of subsets admits a secret sharing scheme. So every monotone increasing family of subsets is the access structure of a scheme. Now we will present a general construction. That is, Given a monotone increasing family of subsets, we will construct a scheme realizing this family. So given a monotone increasing family of subsets gamma, what we can do is to share the secret independently for every subset A in gamma with the simple scheme we saw before. That is, we give a random element to each participant, except for the last participant in A, who will receive S minus the sum of the random elements. We can do it slightly better by sharing the secret independently only for those subsets in the minimal access structure. Now we analyze which is the share size of this construction. So if we want to share a secret that is just one bit, we'll take the previous scheme with fp equals f2. And since each participant, maybe in up to n minus 1, choose n over 2 minus 1 minimal authorized subsets, we have this upper bound on the max share size, that is 2 to the n minus small o of n. So an open problem in secret sharing is to find better constructions for general access structures. So Ito, Saito, and Nishiseki found the first general construction of secret sharing that is somehow similar to the one I presented before. Then Benalo and Leichter presented another technique to construct schemes for general access structure, and also Brickell, Kashmir, and Victorson. But the upper bound was still, on the share size, was still the same. Recently, Liu and Baikun-Tanatan presented a construction in which the share size is smaller, and it was done by constructing the schemes with a conditional disclosure of secret protocols. Then this work of Liu and Baikun-Tanatan was followed by other works, and right now the best upper bound on the share size for general access structure is this upper bound. And we also have lower bounds. So Sirmas proved that there is a family of access structures that have the property that any secret sharing scheme realizing one of these access structures must have share size n over log n, or omega of n over log n. So this is the best lower bound we have for general access structure. And so we have a huge gap between upper and lower bounds. And we would like to know if we can reduce the upper bound, or is that we can find better lower bounds. So that was our starting point. And observe that the bounds we had presented before are upper bounds for the worst case, that is upper bounds for all access structures. And to gain some understanding of this problem, we studied the share size for almost all access structures. And this is because in complexity theory, many times almost all objects are the hardest. And so we want to know if this is the case of secret sharing. And in this work, we found better upper bounds on the share size for almost all access structures and almost all graph access structures. And we also found better lower bounds for almost all access structures. The main techniques and tools we used are robust conditional disclosure of secrets protocols, which is a cryptographic primitive that was recently introduced, and results on monotone Boolean functions, graphs, and matrices. Now we'll see the results we got for almost all access structures. And what we found are better upper bounds on the share size for almost all access structures. And to do that, we combined a result by Korshunov about properties of monotone Boolean functions and the construction of Liu and Baikun-Tanatan, I mentioned before, from that uses conditional disclosure of secret protocols. And then we used different CDS protocols. Now I will give an idea of how we got this upper bound, but before that I need to introduce some notation. I introduce Fn, that is the family of access structures with on n parties, and in general we say that almost all access structures satisfy a property Q if the limit when n tends to infinity of the access structures in Fn that satisfy this property divided by the number of access structures in Fn is 1. So in order to find these results for almost all access structures, we considered another family of access structures that is we call slice access structures. An access structure is a slice access structure if all subsets of size greater than n over 2 plus 2 are authorized, and subsets of size smaller than n over 2 minus 1 are forbidden. And subsets of size between these two thresholds may be authorized or forbidden. There are no restrictions. So this situation is somehow illustrated in this picture, where we have a region that in red of authorized subsets, a region in white with forbidden subsets, and in between we have a pink region in which we have subsets that are authorized or forbidden. So Korsunov found that almost all access structures are of this kind. And moreover, we know that each slice access structure admits a scheme with shared size 2 to the big O of square root of n log n. This was found by, driven by Kuntanaton. So combining these two results, we have that almost all access structures admit schemes with this shared size. These schemes we constructed here are not linear, and we obtain in a similar way upper bounds for linear segregation schemes. And it was by taking the same construction but with linear CDS protocols. And taking multilinear CDS protocols, we got multilinear schemes with a amortized shared size 2 to the big O of square root of n log n. And this is the table of the results we got. So multilinear schemes can be seen as a generalization of linear schemes, and are schemes in which the secret is a sequence of elements from a finite field, and the shares are generated by linear mappings. And the amortized shared size is the shared size divided by the size of the secret, which sometimes is also called information rating. We also got lower bounds, and we proved that for almost all access structure, the total shared size of linear segregation schemes over FQ is omega of 2 to the n over 3 minus small o of n times log Q for every finite field. That is, for almost all access structure, it holds that for every finite field, the total shared size of linear segregation schemes have this restriction. We got this result by using counting arguments and a recent bound on the number of representable matrix. And notice that there was a previous result that obtained the same lower bound, but it was for each finite field. So this is a summary of the upper bounds and lower bounds we have for almost all access structures and all access structures. Now we go for results on graph segregation schemes, but first we will have to introduce what are graph segregation schemes. So graph segregation schemes are schemes in which the minimal authorized subsets are of size 2. Since are of size 2, the family of minimal authorized subsets defines a graph, and so we talk about graph segregation schemes. So let G be an undirected graph. We will define gamma G as the access structure in which the minimum authorized subsets are the edges of the graph. And then schemes realizing gamma G are called G secret sharing schemes. So we have an example here. We have a graph with these three edges, and the access structure determined by this graph is the access structure in which the minimal authorized subsets are the edges of the graph. Okay, so graph secret sharing schemes have been studied in many previous works, and using the simple scheme we had before, or the simple construction we had before, we can construct a scheme in which the share size is n minus 1. Erdos and Piber found a better construction in which the max share size is n over log n. And the best lower bound is log n. So still, for graph secret sharing, we have a huge gap between upper bounds and lower bounds, and we wanted to study the problem of the optimizing the share size for this family of access structures. In our work, we introduced a family of schemes that are called GD secret sharing schemes, that are schemes in which the minimal authorized subsets are, GD secret sharing schemes are schemes in which the authorized subsets are those containing an edge of the graph, G, or subsets of size greater than D. So a subset is authorized if it contains an edge or its size is greater than D. For T equals 2, these schemes are also called forbidden graph secret sharing schemes. And a key observation for our results is that if T is greater than the max size of the independent sets of the graph, then gamma G union gamma T is gamma G. That it implies that GT secret sharing schemes will be G secret sharing schemes when T is greater than the max size of the independent sets of G. Now what we will see is how we got the upper bound on the share size of for almost all graphs. So this is an example of G2 secret sharing schemes. So G is the same as before, and this is the access structure of G2 secret sharing schemes. So the access structure is the same except for this set that now is authorized because we took T to be 2. And so every subset of size T is authorized. So in order to find our upper bounds, we found a new connection between robust CDS protocols, which is a primitive introduced by Applebaum, Beimel, Neer, and Peter recently, and GT secret sharing schemes. This connection extends the connection between CDS and forbidden graph secret sharing schemes that there was before. And by means of this connection, we found that for every graph, there is a GT secret sharing scheme with max share size n to the small o of 1 times t. Okay, and how we got an upper bound for almost all access structures? So with this GT secret sharing scheme taking a small enough t. And this was by observing that the size of maximal independent sets of random graphs is big O of log n. And for this reason, taking t to be big O of log n, for almost all graphs, GT schemes realize gamma G. So GT schemes are G schemes. Therefore, taking T to be big O of log n, we have that almost all graphs admit schemes with max share size n to the small o of 1. And this is these are the upper bounds we got. Again, this construction, this scheme is not linear. And so we consider the linear case. So we found also linear schemes for almost all graphs and multilinear schemes. And this is a complete picture of the situation. So these are the upper bounds for almost all graphs. And we So we can see here that the upper bounds for all Mosel graphs are in between the upper bounds for forbidden graphs and for all graphs. And the same happens for other efficiency measures and also for the lower bounds. And also another thing to mention here is that we found that almost all graphs require admit schemes with information ratio O tilde of log n, while there are graphs that require information ratio omega of square root of n. And for that is for this case, for the information ratio of multilinear schemes, almost all graphs are not the hardest. But this is something we cannot conclude from the other results we got from other efficiency measures. We extended these results for graphs to specific families of graphs, in particular to graphs from the GNP Erdős-Reni distribution, for which we presented upper bounds on the shear size. And also, we provided better schemes for all very dense graphs, improving previous constructions. Also, we extended these constructions from graphs to hypergraphs, and we found better Secretaria schemes for axis structures determined by K hypergraphs, that are hypergraphs in which hyperedges are of size K. And these are the results we got in this work. And now we go for some conclusions and open problems. So what we saw in this work is that for almost all axis structures, there exist Secretarian schemes that are more efficient than the known schemes for the worst case. And this is also the case for almost all graphs. Now we see some open problems. One question is if there are, if almost all axis structures are the hardest, and if we can extend the upper bounds for almost all axis structures to all axis structures. What we saw is that at least for the information ratio of multilinear schemes, we cannot do it, but the answer may differ for different efficiency measures and families of axis structures. Another question is there a Secretarian scheme with polynomial amortized shear size for almost all axis structures? And this question is motivated by a recent result in which we found that slice one axis structures admit schemes with amortized maximum shear size that is polynomial. It is big O of n squared. And the last open question is that if we can extend this approach and these results to other cryptographic primitives with information theoretic security. For instance, to PSM protocols, MPC protocols, MPC protocols with some restrictions, or private information retrieval. And with these open problems, I conclude the presentation of this work, and thank you for your attention.